These are the MacFly Paramotors, and they're full titanium. Every piece of the frame is titanium.
3, 2, 1.
Now that's upside down.
Hey everybody, I'm Matt Minyard, and I'm at my shop, Paramotor in Louisiana, where we teach you guys how to fly. We keep a lot of gear, and we love varieties of gear. And today, we have this beautiful equipment from MacFly. These paramotors are awesome, and I've grown to love these paramotors more and more every time I fly them, simply because the craftsmanship is just amazing. These are full titanium frames, and the ones I buy are folding cages. So we're gonna dive into that. But first, let's talk about the MacFly Moster 185. This is my old engine. I've flown this one on a big Red Bull trip through Southeast Asia, and it's racked up quite some time. This thing's been around, and this motor, we've got a gold ceramic coat on the pipe. So that looks really different than the normal, but we wanted to try a new color. This MacFly Paramotor has a 138 centimeter cage and can fit the 125 or the 130 prop. It's a very strong frame, and it's a very light frame, and it's good for travel. So it checks all the three boxes that are important for me and my style. And it flies like a dream. This thing flies totally dialed in. The anti-torque is visible, it works. There is still torque just like every other motor in the world, but this one flies really, really straight, and I love how it works. And we'll dive over to this side and look at the Atom 80 MacFly. This has been really, really, really awesome because it's made training so easy. Now the machines are so light and powerful thanks to this new 80. It's more powerful than the previous 80s. And it's easy to start. My girlfriend can start it with the motor on her back, and she's pretty weak. So it's easy to start. You go over it, it's got a carbon fiber prop, a cooling shroud on the motor, nice airbox with a filter, super quiet exhaust. The MacFly you can get with a 10, 12, or 18 or 19 liter tank. So I get the 12 liter tank. I can go for a few hours. That's about, what, 3 gallons of fuel? You can get a 5 gallon fuel tank. If you're into cross country and you're trying to build that epic cross country machine, I would stick a 5 gallon fuel tank on the back of this MacFly, and then I would get the big cage on it, because you can get that. So this is 138 centimeter cage. You can get a 1500 centimeter cage and swing a 140 or 145 centimeter prop. And then you can build the ultimate cross-country machine. So I know the trend these days is cross-country, long-distance paramotor adventures. I know all about it. I did a few adventures myself. So that's why I'm using these, and I'm loving these. And these are all my favorite paramotors here in this room. And I just want to highlight some awesome features. So we're going to leave this one put together, but we'll turn it around. And we'll show you guys the front side. This thing is very durable. It's built for the job. This is not a compromise of a unit. When it gets light and strong and small and refined, sometimes there's a little bit of left out information, but in this guy, it has covered every single target that I love. And we've also got a different set of swing arms. We've got an acro swing arm for guys doing stalls and spins and acro. I've got the acro set. Okay, so I have the acro arm here at the moment. I've not stalled it, so I haven't put the acro arm on this one. But when fair weather allows, we're gonna bolt this guy up. So let's unwrap the acro arm. So, ooh, wow. Ooh, that just feels amazing. It's like double walled. Jeez, these guys are on it. So when I'm talking about high quality gear, you just look and admire this weld. It looks perfect. This looks incredible. Yeah, so when you take a close-up and look at this, the weld quality is premium. So we're talking about high-end. This is your safety. So let's do a side-by-side. If this is not the Acro arm, let's look at what the Acro arm looks like next to it. So you see the swing arm is in its in-flight position. Then the Acro arm, you can see the reinforcement across the bottom is the main difference. Yeah, so I imagine if the arm's too weak, this part would probably bend up, but this is the reinforcement. And definitely the gauge of the metal is thicker on this pipe than this pipe, so that's pretty good to see. You can feel some weight behind it, not as light as the other arm. For all the Acro dudes looking to do Acro and fly super aggressive and try and bend all the machines, we've got the Acro arm for you guys to do the Acro, so we know what you want. But this is just a casual flying setup here. You've got the sup air harness on the front, nice and comfortable, very padded, very, very comfortable harness in flight. I put the Vitarazzi V throttle on this one. Really love the feeling. And I put a throttle return spring on every motor, so my throttle whips back, doesn't get stuck. But really, when you look at every paramotor, when you look up close to the welding and you pay attention to all the details of what kind of hardware they use, what kind of safety devices they have on it, this one checks out in every single department. So that's why I'm using it. It's a pretty simple decision. I want to fly and be the best at it. Not in the world, I'm not looking for a world record, but I think if you pick the best gear, you're better off than if you pick the worst kind of gear. And we're not saying this one is the best or any of these are the best, but for me, the way I measure it, this one is at the top of the list. Let's put it on. Can't really resist. So you put your hands through the shoulder straps, kind of kneel down, put it on your back. It just fits like a glove. Even this position is really comfortable. So I like to rock forward and then you just stand up like that. We're gonna get buckled in and we're gonna go over this harness with you. This is the Sup Air paramotor harness. For guys who don't know, the MacFly has been around for several years and flown by a good buddy of mine named Alex Mateos, who happens to be the world champion of paramotoring. So after spending a few trips with him, roommates and such on the road, I've learned that the MacFly paramotor is pretty sweet. I started buying them and gosh, I'm so impressed that it just fits like a glove. But really, it's totally the right fit. You don't even need to use your hands to get in the seat. The seat just kind of pops right under your butt when you need it, goes up when you need to land. I'll tell you what though, if you're a big wide guy, we're gonna have to do a custom made machine, because this is not wide. This thing fits like a glove. So if you see the gap, this is probably an inch or so more narrow than your standard paramotor. It fits like a glove. I kept saying that a few times, and that's what I mean. So the hours I've put on this, I can tell you it flies really, really nice. I like to throw down, and I like when the paramotor fits me really tight. For example, if you're into Acro and your paramotor's really not adjusted properly and too baggy and loose, it's not really gonna suit you well in the long run. So, but anyway, this paramotor is super light. It's also very strong. I can do a power forward inflation with this cage. Super light, super strong MacFly. We already talked about it. You guys know that. Now let's take it apart. How does this thing fit into my car? I said it travels, but let's start from the top. Velcro here. Another Velcro here. Yeah, so you split the top section. There you go. Slide off this little guide for the pull start. Let me come around. I usually do it on this side. So This is a little tight fit on this guy here, but it comes right off. So what I'm talking about is this piece. You see, slides off, you keep it fastened. Now your pull starts disconnected. So you go to the sides, you have these Velcros, and I didn't even know MacFly had a folding cage until I started to get them and appreciate the folding cage. So this cage section is now free and comes off. And you see the beautiful quality here in these hinges. That's what blew me away, was the fit and finish and the attention to detail on this machine. So nice. And then, because I like to travel, that big one first, and then the small, I think it's the small, and then the big one. Look at that. So you can take your cage and just fold it up. They have sweet travel bags. We've got all that stuff in the back. But let's just take it apart and show you the whole section. So again, this is the main point that you pull open. Once that opens, your cage slides off. This thing is so light. It's literally, as light as you can get. So then you get to the bottom, got another Velcro. Okay, one more on the bottom. Now this is where you put your foot on the frame or something and you pull out. You can see the bottom connection just came off. Then at this point, you go down. So it doesn't look like a folding cage here. And then I pull this, voila. So you're able to have your cage folded up. And again, this is a super, super strong titanium. This isn't plastic and thin stuff. That's weak and brittle. And you look at the weld quality. I mean, every single one, so clean on here. So you guys see it. Let's take it apart again on this side and we'll put the whole thing back. All right, so what I'm gonna do is put all the cages together. And then let's imagine we're going somewhere. Gotta put this in the back of the truck. Put these little clips on. And then stick your cage. You can get the sweet travel bag for the cage. Whoa, looks like I'm getting in a tangled up mess here. But something like that. Good to go. This is the very unofficial way to pack it, but this is kind of what I would do if I'm hitting the road doing a little cross country on my own. I wouldn't bring a bag. Let's figure this thing out. All right. Okay, so we got one section. Looks like the top. Okay, got another section. Looks like the bottom. Okay, so we connect these two. Voila. This goes to the top. This plastic insert, rubbery sleeve goes to the bottom. So I come over here. Stage one, put this into here. And then stage two, make these meet up. So I'm gonna pull up on the cage. Voila, there you go. Then with these two in, go here on the side. A little bit of force. And then I put on my Velcro, nice and tight. There you have it, one more. One more in the bottom. So so we're back in action on this side. Now let's go to this side. Got the bottom. All the strings look great. So again, I start here, slide up, then I slide this on. You see, you want a tight fit. Love that, fits very snug. We'll tighten down the Velcro. All right, one more and we're done. Here we go. So it pretty much falls into place. Not very difficult. All right, here we go. All right, so the bottom, the side, one more Velcro here. Okay, so now it can be painful to take off your cage because you have to put on your pull start and untie the rope and all that, but this is not painful at all. So I'm just gonna slide on my pulley. It's already there. Bottom and the top. Do my Velcro. Then we send it. Pretty straightforward. So there you have it. Fully functioning, strong net, very, very tough. That's it. Take the cage off, put the cage on, no tools. Took a few minutes, not really hard. I'd say that's job well done. Then we've got over here the Atom 80. We'll circle back to this little guy. This is a sweet motor if you're just getting into the sport. Even though we love the Moster, and everybody wants to get a Moster for the most part. The Atom 80 is the best entry-level motor I've ever seen. When I first started flying, I bought a Top 80 because that was the best at the time. But nowadays, the Atom 80 has at least met or exceeded greatly every quality of the Top 80. And everyone will agree with that. It's the best part. Starts easy, it's smooth, it's light, it's sexy, it's quiet. I mean, the power is totally smooth, it feels good. If you have a different brand engine, a Pellini engine, an EOS engine, anything, they can just make up a plate to fit your engine. So if you have a good engine and you don't need a whole entire paramotor, you can get the frame and just use the adapter plates here and mount any motor on these frames. So we're gonna spin this little guy around. We're gonna look at them together and show you why these swing arms are different to control the torque of the frame. So the Atom 80, the swing arms both go to the left. The MacFly Moster, the swing arms go to the right. So if the propeller spins down on the pilot's left side, in flight, the pilot's left side, the prop spins down, the arms are offset to the right. You look over here, the prop spins down on the right, the arms are offset on the left. So this is one of the features that we use to cancel out the torque twist. There's a few other features that we have here, but mainly the swing arm controls that. And then it still flies straight when you're off the gas. The older units, you had to do weird things to. But as we look at this Atom 80, the reason why it's so awesome is because it's so lightweight, plus reliability, easy to use, easy to start, easy to restart, silent, smooth throttle application. And then in the MacFly, you can get a really small cage for like those young girls or kids getting into the sport. You can get this thing like in the 35-pound range. It's pretty ridiculous. I think this one's about 40 something pounds. It feels very, very light, you can see. And the same like the Moster over here, it's a little heavier than the Atom 80, but it's still super light. So when you put these on your back, like I was thinking of a contest, how high can you jump with this motor on your back? Because I think I'll hit the ceiling in here. I'm not gonna do it, but geez, this little thing is like It's like nothing on your back, so you should try one, really. It's amazing. Besides that, I think we're just, yeah, I think we covered everything. These are the MacFly Paramotors, and they're full titanium. Every piece of the frame is titanium. So when you think about it, all of it is strong. You've maybe had a bad landing, rolling over, hit the cage on the side. It's strong. It's fine. Yeah, hold on. Getting dry. You've seen the review video of the MacFly. You see why I like these paramotors so much. If you enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, comment down below, whatever questions you have. And please, guys, subscribe to this channel because we want to make more videos for you, and we appreciate you guys watching it so much. Appreciate your attention. These are the MacFly Paramotors, and let us know if you need one of these because they're awesome, and we've got a few of these things in the back. We can build a new one for you. Thanks, guys. See you next time.